What's crack, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Unlimited Super. Hasn't been a video in quite some time, actually, because this whole coronavirus carry on. I've been stuck in work, just haven't had a chance to get out of the cars. And today I'm going to do a compression test on the Rotary RX7. I want to check out how healthy the engine is before I stick in the big turbo. And I've never actually done a compression test before on any car, so but I guess ain't nothing to it but to do it. So let me just talk you through the setup here. So you need a compression tester. I'm just using a normal piston compression tester kit. There are specific rotary compression testers, but they cost a lot of money. First of all, you need to get the car heated up. You want the car up to operating temperature. You need to make sure there's no fuel going in. You need to make sure there's no spark going in. So the easiest way to do that is to remove the fuse. However, I've kind of redneck wired my car, so I can just disconnect the fuel pump and disconnect the ECU. So take out the spark plugs, turn over the car, let all the petrol come out, and then we'll hook up the compression tester on the front rotor, do the same on the back rotor, and that's about it. Other thing you need is, if you're doing this by one person, you need a camera looking at your compression tester so you can look back at the results. Ideally, just need two people doing this, it'd be a lot easier. This is just the standard piston tester kit. And anyone who is unfamiliar with rotaries, they use these different types of spark plugs. So we just need to find a correct fitment of one of these boyos. So that should match up. There's sometimes a valve inside these, but this doesn't actually have the valve. So when I'm doing this, I'll show you later, this button is basically going to need to be held in so I can see the individual pulses for each rotor face. So on a side note, let's just check out the paint job on the old FC. So I'm actually very proud of that paint job. Well, the lighting in my garage is pretty poor, so you can't really tell. But this is a home paint job. I'm not too sure if you've seen it in the other videos, but me and Dave painted this. And so this was kind of led by the Gunman videos on YouTube and Big Dave at the helm. Anyway, let's get back to business. So first off, obviously, you need to do a compression test when it's hot. There's no point doing a compression test when it's cold, because it'll just give you a false readings.
Open up the ventilation system.
So just gotta wait for it to warm up now. Okay, so that's the engine warmed up. And so what we're gonna do is remove one of the leading spark plugs at a time. So that's the bottom spark plugs. Plug in our compression tester. Because this isn't a rotary specific compression tester, this will kind of give you your peak PSI, which is not what I want. So this button here, I'm just going to tape, so then I'll see the three pulses, and I'll set up another camera to try and video the gauge so I can see the pressure. So my engine bay is actually really messy. You probably can't really see down there. I can get a light here. But this is far from a standard engine bay. But the top plugs are blue and the bottom ones are black, so we're taking off those black ones. Pull them off and take the spark plug out with a 21mm socket. So another important step is to basically make sure your engine has no petrol in it. So this is your fuel pump fuse. Crank it over a few times when you've got the spark plug out. You hear that hissing away there? It actually sounds like it's good compression.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up. So
my car is heavily rednecked, so I don't actually need this fuse, but that's your EGI, that's the fuse. Just remove that. Alright, so we'll try and get the compression tester down into the front leading spark plug hole, and then we'll set up a camera and we'll get a reading. Get that snug, just hand tight should do. And then we'll stick this on. Right, so this is the setup. We've got our gauge there. So we've got the camera pointing at the gauge, look at it, but in the highest resolution, 60 frames per second, so we can go in slow-mo. So what we'll do is hit record. So that's the recording. We'll go crank it over. Just the front rotor tested, so we'll look at the GoPro footage and we'll see what's our PSI we were getting, and what we're looking for is three even spikes. Right, so I looked at the GoPro footage. I haven't stuck it on the computer yet, but it looks like it's hitting 60 PSI, front rotor, back rotor. At least it's even, so I don't think there's going to be a blown apex seal. it's really poor PSI across all rotor facings, front and back. Pretty sure I did the compression test right. So I think the motor just needs pulled out and rebuilt.
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
So that means I need to take the motor out. Might as well do some porting when the engine's out. And hopefully there's not too much damage to it. But yeah, so there's no point really chucking in the Gucci turbo in when the engine's a bag of dicks. So that could also explain why whenever I stuck in Johnny's hybrid turbo, it wasn't really making much power. I think whenever I had it last down out at G-Sports, it was only getting 230 to the wheels, which on the spec of the hybrid turbo I have, it should have been hitting 300 to the wheels easy. But for now, that's a definite hats off now for this car. I won't be hitting the drift scene for a long time, which is all right. It means I can work on the V8 car, and also I can focus on doing videos for the other lads at the drift days. Anyway guys, don't forget to click like, hit the subscribe button, follow us on Instagram and Facebook, and stay tuned for the next video. Hopefully it'll not be too much of a wait for the next video now that the coronavirus situation's kind of eased off, but yeah, said it before and said again, that's us now.